Hallelujah.
Yes.
Tricia.
Uh-huh. You are home.
All right. Praise God. Well, happy Sunday morning to you. We want to welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend.
Yes.
Bienvenidos a la iglesia del nuevo comienzo. And we want to welcome all our NBC family visitors and all those of you joining us by audio or video.
Yes.
Amen. Prepare yourselves to receive what God has for you. Amen.
Amen.
I say that all the time, you know. If you're not receiving, it's because you're not prepared. Because he's always wanting to give.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you willing? Are you open for him to come in? You know,
yes.
He's knocking, but you got to open up. If you're not open up, you know, he's not going to force his way in.
That's it.
Amen. He'll come in when you open up.
Yes.
And that's what we need to do. We need to open ourselves up. Hey, somebody's knocking at the door. Don't open the door. It's him again.
Yes.
He's going to keep coming, you know. He keeps sending these friend requests, and you keep deleting them, you know. You got to open up.
Yes.
You got to let him in. Accept, you know, that's the best thing you can do.
Yeah.
Amen. So, praise God.
Praise God.
I'm excited. I don't know about you. I've got a couple of nuggets I want to read to you, but we're going to continue with closing the old and opening the new.
Okay.
Amen. And before we do that, let's read this together. Let's make this declaration together.
Amen.
Grab your Bibles and say it like you mean it. Amen. Do you have one?
Amen.
If not,
yes.
It's time that you get one. Amen. This is all we use. The B-I-B-L-E. That's the word for me. Amen. The B-I-B-L-E. Basic instructions before leaving earth.
Yes.
If you don't know what to do, it's because you haven't read the basic instructions.
That's it.
We got to get into the word. Amen. It's got everything.
That's
every
it.
Question that you've got is
that's
right
it.
Here in the word. Amen.
Amen.
So let's make this declaration together.
Right.
This is
my
Bible.
I am
what it says I am.
I have
what it says I am.
I
can do what it says I can do today. I'll be talking the word of God. I boldly confess. My mind is alert. My spirit is receptive. And I'll never be the same. In Jesus' name. I don't want to be the same. And he don't want you to be the same. We want to change and we want to grow.
Right.
It's called maturity. It's called relationship. When you have relationship, you're going to grow. I want to grow. Amen. It's just like me and Mr. Riz working yesterday. And we had a stepladder. And you know, we had to go up to the roof. But we had to go one step at a time. Amen. You don't go from the bottom to the top. You got to go one step at a time. One day at a time. 1 year at a time. And we grow each and every day, amen,
yes,
in the
yes,
things
yes.
of God.
Yes.
Woo, hallelujah.
Praise God.
Somebody needed that.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I've got a couple of nuggets to you, read to you. And we're going to continue with opening or closing the old and opening the new. You know, if you're going to close the old, close it with a bang. Close it being excited. You know, we're going to close this old year. Oh, we got a new year coming.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm excited about the new year, but you know what? Don't worry about what you didn't accomplish this year. Amen. Just thank God a new year is coming.
Yes.
I've got a chance to do more. Amen.
Lord.
Hallelujah. So praise God. Opening the old, closing the old and opening the new.
Mm-hmm.
And God's not finished with you. He's got great plans for you. Here's the thing. The key thing is, are you available? You got to make yourself available. You know, when it's Christmas time and they're passing out the presents, you make yourself available.
Yes.
I mean, hey, what about me?
Yeah.
Where's mine? You know, I'm available. Well, make yourself available when he's looking for you, when he needs somebody to bless somebody.
Yes.
You know, he blesses you to be a blessing.
Yes.
He just don't bless you so you can get real big and fat with blessings. He wants to bless you so you can bless somebody else.
Yeah.
I'm not attached to things. We've given lots of things. Amen. And it's okay. Bless somebody. You know what? The best thing you can do is make yourself available and bless somebody with a kind word.
Yes.
Praise God. You know, we just had some major, major, major storms. Was it Kentucky?
Kentucky.
And some of these people lost their homes, lost their lives, lost their homes, lost their job, whatever. You know. And pray for them. Remember, there's no distance in prayer.
That's it.
They're way over there. Doesn't mean it stops you from praying.
Right.
You're a child of God.
Yes.
And you can pray for these people. The love and compassion of God just flowing through you.
Mm-hmm.
All you have to do is open your mouth. Amen?
Yes.
Praise God. So make yourself available. And remember, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Confess this over yourself all the time. Yes. I'm a winner. I'm a child of God. Mm-hmm. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I'm a champion. I'm an overcomer. Amen. See yourself that way. You know, when you look in front of the mirror like you do when you get all prettied up, you know. Man, you see this person up there, you know. Of course, that could be your biggest problem. But then again, I'm confessing things over myself.
Amen.
And it's okay for you to speak them out.
Yes.
You know, when we're out there full of stuff, full of that nasty stuff, you know, them drugs or alcohol, whatever, we don't mind speaking them things out. I don't care who heard me. And it don't bother me. So when we're with God, we confess the word of God to ourselves.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Build yourself up. Remember, we're going to be talking about this, but stir yourself up.
Yes.
Nobody's going to stir you up.
That's
Amen.
It.
You got to stir yourself up. Let me read you these nuggets for you. Never be ashamed of what you've been through.
Mm-hmm.
God will use your story for His glory.
Yeah.
We all have an awesome testimony.
That's right.
Amen. The thing about it is we pass through.
Uh-huh.
And we're on His side. We're on the winning side. And He's going to take that story.
Yes.
And God's going to use it. He says they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony.
Amen.
Amen. So when he says share it, share it. No matter what you've been through or what your past was, you will make it.
Yes.
See, God's going to use you to tell somebody that's down and out to say, you know what? I used to be there. You can make it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
I know who you need. You need Christ. Listen to this. Joseph was a prisoner, yet he became a prime minister.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. They sold him. They wanted to kill him first. But then they sold him to slavery.
Mm-hmm.
And every time they put him down, he was raised up. Yes. God's going to promote you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. God's going to promote you. He's not finished with you. Daniel was captive, yet he became governor. Amen. Esther was a slave girl, yet she became a queen. Praise God, you know, work in the fields, whatever. Became a queen. Mary Magdalene was a prostitute.
Oh, yeah.
Seven demons cast out of her.
Oh, boy.
Yet became one of Jesus' most loyal followers.
Yes.
And one of Jesus' most celebrated disciples.
Yes.
Listen to this. David, what a shepherd boy.
Mm.
You know what the world tells you all the time? You're a nobody.
Nobody.
And you start believing this. Mm. And you start putting yourself down and believing these lies.
Mm-hmm.
David was a little shepherd boy.
Yes.
But you know what? That didn't bother him.
That's it.
He said, man, my God delivered me.
Yes.
When the bear came, when the lion came, he says, He delivered me from these things.
Mm-hmm.
So guess what? He was building himself up.
Yes.
He knew who he was in Christ.
Right.
So when David came, the giant came, he knew and said, God is with me.
Mm-hmm.
So when you know whatever's attacking you, whatever giants are facing, you're facing, God is with you.
Yes,
but David was a shepherd boy and became a king.
Mm-hmm.
Man, just think, God has special things for you. And this is the way you see yourself, the way God sees you.
Yes.
Not the way you see yourself, or not the way the world sees you.
Right.
And the world says, you are unqualified. You're no good.
Mm-hmm.
Family says that. No, see yourself the way He sees you. He put you here because you're special.
Amen.
And now you got to fulfill what He called you to be. Amen.
Right.
God will use you or use your story for His glory.
Uh-huh.
Amen. So let's remember this. You are somebody going somewhere to happen for somebody. Amen. None but bad news out there. So what? I'm bringing the good news. See yourself that way. Amen. The Bible says, this is the day the Lord has made. That's one of our texts today. But anyway, you cannot start the new chapter of your life if you keep rereading the past one. And that's where the enemy wants to keep you. That's where family wants to keep you. That's where everybody wants to keep you. I remember you. What do you remember about me? You know, all they remember is the past. And what they know about your past.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. But now let's go to one of our texts is going to be 2 Corinthians 5:17. A lot of us know this, okay? But it's okay. Open the Bible.
Yes.
Because some of you haven't opened your Bibles in a while. So it's time to catch up. 5:17.
Uh-huh.
Amen. It starts in verse 11, but we're going to read verse 17. It's talking about reconciling ministry.
Yeah.
You have been called. If you're here, yes. You're called.
Yes.
I don't have a call in my life. Yes, you do. Well, you know why you don't know? Because you haven't read the word.
Yes,
you
got
to open the word and get into it. Amen.
Amen.
But 2 Corinthians 5:17 says what? Therefore, if any man, woman, okay, be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Okay? We're going to stop right there. But the old is out, the new is in.
Yes.
So you got born again.
Yeah.
This is what we call born again, spiritually born again. Not physically, but spiritually we're born again. I'm a child of God. Old is gone, the new is in. That's what he tells us to do.
Right.
And we need to do the same thing. Even when people in the world is reminding you of what you used to be. I remember you. I can't use you. Okay? You're not qualified.
No.
Okay? No. That's the old me. And you know what? When they tell you these things, says, you know what? You're talking about somebody else. That's not me.
Right.
Physically, you look the same.
Uh-huh.
Maybe you grew higher, taller, wider, or older, but you're the same person.
Right.
And physically, they can see you. But spiritually, they can't see your spirit. They can't see your soul. But I've changed. Amen. And I'm going to start living it and walking it, talking it. Now they say, wow, yeah, that's a new person. Yeah, I'm a new person. And I'm not going to let you take me out of my peace. I'm not going to let you take me out of my joy.
Yes,
amen. I'm walking my walk and talking my talk.
Thank you.
I'm going to keep on doing it.
Yes.
Amen. So don't let nobody come and feed you stuff that want to take you out of your peace.
That's it.
Out of your joy, whatever it is. Amen. So you are the one to say, that's not me. No,
that's
I'm not going there. Delete, delete, delete.
That's it.
Amen. You got to say, renewing your mind with the word of God. Now I'm a new creature in Christ.
Uh-huh.
All these things are going to attack you. But I'm not in the world now. I'm in Him. Amen.
Amen. In Christ.
I don't know. Somebody needed that. I needed it.
Yeah.
Let me see what I wrote. Never start your new day or your new year on neutral.
Oh boy.
You know what neutral is? Being this dispassionate or being lukewarm. Just start neutral. No. We need to be on fire. We need to be passionate for Him. For Christ so loved the world. For God so loved the world. He gave us Jesus.
Yes.
You know? So we need to be on fire for Him. Be passionate about it. When Jesus, you know, He had opportunities and He had problems. And you know what He did? I got to go pray.
Mm-hmm.
Went to the Father and prayed, Lord, I need your help. Father, I need your help. Father, I need your help.
Yes.
And come out positive instead of being negative.
Right, right.
Amen. That's the only way you're going to survive this negative world.
Oh, yeah.
Stay positive by being with Him. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let me read what I wrote here. Never start your day in neutral or lukewarm.
Oh, boy.
It says a card is a great invention. Guess what? It's very helpful. But you know what? You got to do something. You got to choose what you want to do. If you want to move forward, you got to put it in drive.
Yeah.
Or even if you got to go backwards, you put it in neutral. Reverse.
Reverse, yeah.
But you know what? If you put it on neutral, you ain't going anywhere.
Nowhere.
You're not going to grow in Him by staying neutral.
That's it.
By staying lukewarm. By straddling the fence and saying, I'm not for God. I'm not for the enemy. I'm just me.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Mm-hmm.
You got to do something.
Right.
Amen? So, we have to do something. We must choose.
Mm-hmm.
You got to choose drive, reverse, neutral. You got to choose being positive, being negative.
Mm-hmm.
You got to choose going up or going down.
That's it.
Am I going with Him or am I going with Him?
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Come on in, brother. Hey, Mr. Riz. Psalms 118:24 says, this is the day the Lord has made. Mm-hmm. Some translation says, we will rejoice. Some say, I will rejoice. Some say, let us rejoice.
Uh-huh.
You know, as we assemble ourselves together, let us rejoice. Let us rejoice.
Yeah.
Another word for rejoice is being happy.
Yeah.
Another word for rejoice is celebrating.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You know what? When you're a child of God and, and he calls you home,
yeah,
it's a homegoing celebration.
Mm-hmm.
This is a homegoing celebration. I don't want nobody to be sad.
Mm.
Amen. And I don't want nobody coming crying over me, you know. And you ain't come visit me while I'm alive. Now you come cry over me while I'm dead.
Oh, Jesus.
You know, I'm letting you know right now. You're listening to me. Don't come.
You won't be.
I'm going to have a homegoing celebration. If you don't come to be happy and rejoice, don't come. Let me finish. This is the day the Lord has made.
Uh-huh.
I, and remember, take the I, make it personal.
Mm-hmm.
I, put your name there, Jose, yes, will rejoice, celebrate, and be glad,
yes,
or happy, cheerful in it.
Yes.
It's a new day. The only day, I keep saying this all the time, the only day we ever happy is, thank God it's Friday.
Yeah.
Well, what about Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday,
that's
and Thursday?
It.
Saturday,
right.
Sundays?
Right.
No, thank God for every day you wake up.
That's it.
Your first miracle is you woke up. You,
yes,
open your eyes. Thank you, Lord, for this day.
Yes.
Amen. He's given us a new day to serve him.
Right.
And I'm excited to go and share with people and take them out of the pits of hell.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. Start by rejoicing, being glad. Start by praising him. Start by stirring up.
Yes.
Start by having an attitude of gratitude,
mm-hmm,
having a winning attitude,
right,
and not a losing attitude.
Right, right.
You know, you get in a losing attitude, well, that always happens to me, you know. Well, that's the way it is all the time, you know.
Uh-oh.
It's just me, poor little old me. You need to control this.
Yes.
Amen. When you see yourself the way he sees you, you're not going to be confessing these things.
That's it.
You're going to be positive and not negative. But it's your choice.
Yeah.
You know, let me see how I want to say this.
Nice.
You know, you got a nice, let's just say, you don't let nobody come to your house, open your door, and empty their trash in your house.
Mm-mm.
You say, wait a minute, that's not going to happen. Well, guess what? People use words to trash you up.
Mm-hmm.
Don't receive it.
That's
amen.
It.
I'm not a trash can.
That's it.
I'm not a dumpster for you to come dump all your negative,
right,
or all,
right,
your trash on me.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? It's up to me to say, I don't receive it.
Amen.
If you receive it, you're going to fight with it. Mm-hmm. And the enemy's going to attack.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. The battlefield, remember, the battlefield is the mind.
Right.
And it's a spiritual battle. And he's going to use that to try to bring you down. Positive,
right,
negative.
Right.
And you're going to struggle,
mm-hmm,
with that.
Mm-hmm.
Whew, we haven't even got our first base yet.
Right.
Start setting priorities.
Mm-hmm.
Start setting priorities. We all have priorities.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever you happen to be, whether you're at home or you're at work, wherever you happen to be, even if you're retired, you still have priorities. Amen. So you got to set your priorities. What's my priority? My priority is seek ye first the kingdom of God. Matthew 6:33. It goes like this. It says, but you have lots of things or lots of priorities. So it says, but seek first the kingdom of God,
mm-hmm,
his righteousness, and all these things shall be added on,
yes,
to you.
Mm-hmm.
You got to make that choice.
Yes.
You know, you can keep the door closed,
mm-hmm,
and keep the negative things out, or you can just let anybody pass by and trash you up.
Mm-hmm.
No. No, no. First thing, I'm going to seek him. Amen. Seek him first.
Mm-hmm.
And all these other things shall be added unto me.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway, here's what we're trying to do. Let it go in the past.
Yes.
Let it go. It's gone. You know, some people, somebody listening should really need this.
Mm.
You know, you got to let go of the past. It happened,
yeah,
20 years ago, 30 years ago,
gosh,
and you're still struggling with that.
Mm-hmm.
And we got to take care of the now,
mm-hmm,
not the past, not tomorrow's.
That's,
you know,
it.
Tomorrow's got enough worries for itself.
That's it.
Let me see. I want to tell you this way. If he's taken it from you, if he's forgiven and forgotten it,
mm-hmm,
why are you still holding on to it?
Mm-hmm.
It's the battlefield of the mind.
Mm-hmm.
You got to renew it to what the Word of God says and,
yeah,
just let it go.
Yeah.
Amen. And start new. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Let go of past failures, mm-hmm. past mistakes, past problems, worries, lacks, bad habits, negative attitudes, and prepare for the new day.
Right.
For the new year, whatever it may be.
Yeah.
But we have to let those things go. Mm-hmm. You have a choice.
Yes.
Nobody can do it for you.
That's it.
Amen. And Philippians 3, last week, we're continuing with letting go and letting God.
Yes.
Philippians 3, 12, and, 12 through 14, New Living Translation says, I don't mean to say that I have already achieved these things, mm-hmm. or that I have already reached perfection.
Right.
But I press to possess the perfection for which God, for which Christ Jesus first possessed me.
Mm-hmm.
It says, no, dear brothers and sisters, I have not achieved it, but I focus on this one thing.
Yeah.
Forgetting the past,
yes.
and looking forward to what is lies ahead.
Yes,
it says, I press to reach the end of the race. Yes. I receive my heavenly prize for which God, through Christ Jesus, is calling me.
Yes.
He's calling us home. He wants us home, but we got to fulfill and complete what he's called us to do.
Yeah.
And one of the things he's called us to do is forget your past. Don't carry the cares. Cast them on him, he says. Don't carry these things. Don't carry these extra weights.
That's it.
He knows what it takes to fulfill on a daily basis.
Mm-hmm.
And we got to cast out the old and press on with the new. Amen.
Yes. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
You,
start every day, every new year, by staying positive in a negative world and circumstances. Don't let the world and circumstances take you out of your peace, out of your joy. You bring them into your peace.
Yes,
amen. You bring them into your peace.
Mm-hmm.
And if they don't want to, then you just got to go.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're to share the word of God with people. It's not up to you to convince them.
That's it.
And make them.
That's right.
Receive it. It's mm-hmm. up to them.
Yeah.
Amen. All we're doing is sowing a seed.
That's it.
Amen. We're sowing a seed.
That's it. God,
this is all God told me to say.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to say it. And I'm going to leave it there. And he's going to take care of it.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to water it. He's going to make sure that it comes to increase.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not up to me. Amen. I'm not going to beat him over the head and say this, do this.
Mm-hmm.
No. I sowed the seed. It's time for me to go.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody else is going to come,
yes.
and do the rest.
Yes.
But he's going to use somebody else.
Right.
So it's not up to me to just stay there and try mm-hmm. to change them.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I'm not into changing. God is. I'm not into judging. He
That's
is.
It.
Amen. So praise God. Here's the thing. The Amplified Bible says in Philippians 4:8, finally, believers, finally, brethren, this is the Amplified. Finally, believers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is
right.
worthy of respect, whatever is
yes.
right and confirmed by God's word,
mm-hmm.
whatever is pure and wholesome,
mm-hmm.
whatever is lovely and brings peace,
yes.
whatever is admirable and of good repute,
mm-hmm.
if there's any excellence, if there's anything worthy of praise, think continually on these
yes.
things. Huh? Center your mind on them. And implant them in your heart or your spirit.
Yes.
Amen. He tells us what to think about.
Yes.
So renew your mind, get the old.
Yes.
Get the stink out and put the new things in. Amen.
Yeah.
You don't have to. Nobody forces you to think a certain way.
That's right.
You're allowing yourself,
right.
and you have to stop it. Renew myself with the Word of God. You know, when you know the word of God and something is pulling you away, you know
yes.
what you need to do.
Right.
You say, wait a minute, I'm getting pulled away. That GPS is going the wrong way.
Yes.
You know, this lady's telling me the wrong thing. You know, the lady always comes on and tells you where to turn, what to do. So 2 Corinthians 5:17, we read it a few minutes ago, says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is what? A new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Woo! Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm going to read you this, and you can mark this down in Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 through 4. It's in the easy-to-read version. I'm talking about a new life in Him.
Uh-huh.
Amen. It says, you were raised from dead with Christ.
Yeah.
So live for what is in heaven, where Christ is sitting at the right hand of God.
Uh-huh.
Christ sits at the right hand of God,
yes,
a place of authority.
Right.
And he intercedes for us.
Yeah.
So don't ever see yourself as just being by yourself or lonely and nobody cares about you.
Right.
Christ, Jesus,
yes,
is always interceding,
yes,
for you. But if you don't know what the word says, mm-hmm, enemy is going to trip you, mm-hmm, and have you thinking that you all know nobody's for you. Well,
right,
he is for you. Amen.
Yes,
he's sitting at the right hand of God. Think only about what's up there, not where, not what is here on earth.
Right.
Your old self has died and the new life is kept with Christ in God.
Yes.
Yes, Christ is now your life.
Right.
And when he comes again, we will share his glory.
Yes.
Amen. So he's telling you what to do. This is,
yes,
new life in Christ.
Right.
Old is gone, new is in.
Mm-hmm.
No matter how much people, family tries to tell us, mm-hmm, you know, you're the same person.
Right.
You ain't changed. Yes, I've changed. And if they haven't changed and they're still doing the same things, they don't know Christ.
Right.
They may talk it, but they're not living it.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not speaking it.
That's it.
Because the Bible says in Ephesians 5, 1 and 2,
mm-hmm,
in the Amplified, it says that we're to imitate, be imitators of Christ.
Right.
And we don't go around doing these things. Amen. So the past things we must release, let go and let God. We must clean ourselves in our spiritual life.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, it's a spiritual battle.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot defeat the spirit world with your physical self. You need the word of God. Amen.
That's it.
Cast it on him, release it, let it go, renew your minds. Things try to attach themselves to our life, let them go. Things,
yes,
don't have a place in our lives.
Right.
And then we're to renew our minds.
Renew
this is,
mind.
And somebody really needs to hear this.
Uh-huh.
You can, as a child of God, you can renew your mind.
Amen.
If you don't know Christ, it's time that you know him.
Yes.
And know that you can renew your mind with the word of God.
That's it.
Amen. Whatever the Lord takes, let it go. Don't take it back.
That's it.
Stop remembering what God, this is what I was looking for a few minutes ago. Stop remembering what God has already forgiven and forgotten. Why are you still remembering? Was it not good enough that he forgave and forgot you? Why are you still holding on to it? It says, let it go. Stop. Don't go there anymore. Paul tells us in Colossians 3 and 2, it says, focus our thoughts on heavenly things. Avoid getting caught up in worldly things. Things that pollute our minds. Things or people that hinder our walks. Distractions. There's going to be lots of distractions. Amen. You might have a great GPS going somewhere from here to wherever you're going. But you know what? There might be a detour that says, hey, you know, today there's going to be something this way. There's work going on this way. So you got to go this way and this way. Well, the word of God tells you, you know what? I don't want you to go this way today. I want you to go this way. And guess what? There was a major something, accident or whatever, happening there. And he took you another way because you was focusing on him.
Yeah.
Amen? And when we're in the spirit and receiving these things, we don't let the distractions hold us back.
Amen?
Amen. So, praise God. Focus the mind on the things of God. Renewing your mind. That's, again, Paul mentions about some distractions,
uh-huh,
that can hinder our walks.
Yeah.
False doctrines. False doctrines. The enemy would love for people to get themselves trapped in some of these false doctrines, false teachings that takes the emphasis off of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Be careful. Amen. There's not no new thing. The Bible covers it all. There's no new teachings, there's no new diseases that people are coming up with.
Uh-huh.
In Christ, stripes were put on Jesus. He covered it all. So if somebody says, hey, you know, you ought to come to our place, you ought to come to our teachings, you know, we got new things going,
uh-huh,
on, not the old stuff.
That's the new one.
Right there, it tells you,
mm-hmm,
don't go.
Mm-hmm.
Don't go. Praise God. It's the new, the gospel, the word of God,
yeah,
the living word of God, the traditions of men, not of God. We're not to base our faith and our walk on the tradition of men, no matter how godly or worthy of respect a man may be. We are to base our belief system on the Word of God only.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I don't know about you, but we were raised a certain way. And they said, we're going to do it this way because this is the way we do it. But what does the Word of God says? If the Word of God says, do it this way, then put that aside and go with what the Word of God says.
That's it.
Somebody tells you something different than what the Word of God says, you have to know what the Word of God says.
Right.
And if you know what the Word of God says, somebody try to feed you something else.
Mm-hmm.
Then this is the way we do it here. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to join us, you got to do it this way.
No.
I say adios. Mm-hmm. I'm out of here. Take yourself out of there. Mm-hmm. Don't even take a step or open a door for anything like that. Amen.
That's it.
So, as we come to our new day or we come to the new year with new opportunities, new assignments, and new beginnings, know that God has something special for you.
Yes,
I have great plans for you. Mm-hmm. He's talking to you. He's not talking about somebody else.
Right.
See, we've been thought that, well, it's for somebody else. You know, that's not me. Poor little old me. I could never do anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
You remember, we are the body of Christ.
Yes.
And the Bible talks about, in Romans talks about the body, and in Corinthians too, it talks about the body having many parts, but it's one body. All these parts in this body make this body function well.
That's it.
Amen. Makes it function well, and they all operate in unity.
Right.
And this is what we need in the body of Christ, walking together in unity.
Yes.
Together. Amen. Thank God these body parts don't start fighting against each other. We'd be a mess.
Right.
But all these things, and you know what? You can't exclude from the little parts to the big parts.
That's
or
it.
The major organs.
That's it.
Because you need your eyes. If you don't have your eyes, you couldn't see. If you didn't have your ears, you couldn't hear.
That's it.
You know, your mouth, you couldn't talk. Mm-hmm. Your little toes, you know, you couldn't walk.
Mm-hmm.
So every part in this body is vital, important.
Yes,
you are that part in the body of Christ. Don't see yourself small, see yourself big. No, I just see myself as being a part of the body of Christ and being there to serve Him and do for Him. Amen?
Yes.
See yourself that way, because the world is going to try to exclude you and say, that's not good enough. That's not big enough. Or they'll say, you know what you've done? He can't use you anymore. So you better just sit and do nothing.
Mm-mm.
No.
No.
No, no, no. Remember, we talked about Joseph, we talked about David. They had sinned. All these Bible heroes you talk about, they had sinned in their lives. But God still used them mightily.
Yes, he did.
Amen. So, we've all sinned and come short, but still, He's going to use you.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to use me. Amen. You see yourself that way.
Yes.
So, our first start of a new day, a new year. Things we can do is, personally, we can start improving ourselves by not only physically, but spiritually.
Yes.
Getting in the Word of God.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Hallelujah. Don't let people, things, or excuses hold you back.
That's it.
We do that a lot, you know. If your mind is not in Christ, if your mind is not renewed to the things of God, the enemy is going to put thoughts, and you're going to start thinking wrong.
Right.
And you're going to say, well, I'll pay him this way.
Mm.
I'll do this.
Mm.
But you're going to be wrong.
Yeah.
Amen. You're going to be wrong. You know, Jesus could have wiped them all out.
Yeah.
But he didn't.
That's right.
At the end, he told Father, forgive them.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And you know what?
Amen.
There's a lot of people out there you really hate.
Yeah.
And a lot of people out there that really bug you. There's a lot of hateful people out there.
Yes, there is.
But here's the thing. Remember this. Christ died for them too.
Yes, he did.
And salvation is for them too.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And it's up to us to get the hateful out and let the love and compassion of God flow through us.
Amen.
Amen. So He can use us. I'm a channel. I'm here, Lord, to use me, even to speak to somebody that I don't want to talk to, that I hate, that is hateful, that has done something real bad to you.
Mm-hmm.
And God's going to use you to go and say something to him. Say, man, I don't talk to that person.
Mm.
What if they drop dead and you had an opportunity God gave you to share with them? Mm-hmm. Maybe one day you stand before God and says, I gave you an opportunity to talk to them. And that was their last resource and you passed it up. Mm-hmm. Just think. Excited to close out the old and open the new. Mm-hmm. Pressing towards the goal. Hey, you know what? Hey, I'm excited. You know, hey, we got New Year coming. Man, you know, I'm up in age now, and I don't know what I want to do. You know, hey, I'm still stuck on this year. No, unstick yourself. Amen. It's time to move, pass on, move forward. Again, Philippians 4:13. You mark that down. 12-14 talks about passing on, pressing on. Amen. You got to learn that word. I'm going to press on with him. Amen. Amen. I can't leave. I can't go anywhere without him because he says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. He's always with me. So I don't care how much you try to hide, he's there with you. Mm-hmm. Amen. So I'm going to press on. If I'm going to press on, he's with me.
Yes, he is.
So whatever's facing me, whatever giants are coming against me, God's with me. And you know what they do? I want them to see who's backing me. He's backing me, and I'm going to press on. Press towards the goal for the prize. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Let me see. Mm-hmm. Don't be a slave of the past. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people have.
That's it.
Paul said, I've done the worst. But he didn't let the past hold him captive. Amen?
That's it.
He said, I persecuted Christians. I had them executed. There's no hope for me. Mm. Sounds familiar? He was going around killing Christians.
Yes.
And he had a close encounter with God.
Yes, he did.
He was going to do some more. God just knocked him off his horse. You know, while he was on his knees, blind, he still said, man, is this you, Lord? That's Hosea. But he knew God had done this.
Yes.
Says, well, what's up, God? You know, I thought I was doing this for you. Mm. You know, he knocked him off his horse. He changed him.
Yes.
Changed his name.
Yes.
He told the man of God, he says, go lay hands on him. Pray for him. He said, he's coming to his senses now. He said, no. He said, do you know what he's doing? Mm-hmm. Do you get with God? He said, God says, go pray for this person. He said, man, that's an ugly person. Mm. That's a hateful person. You know what they've done to me? Mm. No, I'm not going to go. He said, well, he says, he went anyway.
Yes.
Laid hands on him.
Yes.
And his eyes were open.
Yes.
Amen. Our spiritual eyes were open mm-hmm. when you received him. Amen. The world can't blind you anymore. Mm-hmm. No one can blind you anymore.
That's it.
Amen. I can see. Mm-hmm. Hmm. This is good.
Yep.
There's no way I could ever be used by Christ. Mm. As Paul said, he said, I'm the worst. Mm. Now, if Paul did all those things, he could still use you. Mm-hmm. Are you going to stop believing what somebody told you? So-and-so says, God can't use you anymore. Or you went somewhere and visited somewhere, and they said, hey, you're not good enough mm-hmm. for Christ. You're not good enough to be used by God. Mm. Is that what your Bible says?
No.
If that's not what your Bible says, then put it on the shelf and you know, go somewhere else.
Right.
Amen. God is only looking for, God is not looking for perfect, and I'm going to close with this. Mm-hmm. God is not looking for perfect Christians.
Right.
He's looking for available Christians. He's looking for available servants. See yourself. The Bible says in Matthew that Jesus didn't come to be served. He comes to serve. And he's our greatest example. We can learn to serve him.
Yes.
Amen. Serve him. He's looking for available Christians or believers, whatever you call yourself. Mm-hmm. If you think, God, can I use you? Remember what we talked about a few minutes ago. I mean, you can have a list a mile long of people God used.
Yeah.
Amen. If you know, the world says, you can't be used anymore. Mm. Yes, I can. Mm. Amen.
Amen.
We said this. Sin keeps Christians from fulfilling what God called and equipped you to do.
Right.
Sin. And people use this people to remind you of what you've done and keep you from doing what God has called you to do. But remember, if he's forgiven you and forgotten it, why are you still remembering?
Right.
Why are you still holding on to it?
Mm-hmm.
It's time to let it go
press
on with God. Amen?
That's it.
And this is what I told you last week was sin will take you further than you want to go.
Yes.
Keep you longer than you want to stay and cost you more than you want to pay. Amen? Hallelujah. So we're going to leave it at that.
Praise God.
Says Paul had many years of fruitful ministry after putting his past behind him.
Mm-hmm.
So can we.
Yes.
I don't care what age you are. You know, the world qualifies you and limits you by your age. When you come to Christ, you're not limited.
That's right.
You can do all things through Christ.
Right.
Amen. So don't let those things hold you back. Amen.
Right.
We're going to press on. We're going to press on.
Yeah.
It's never too late. Don't let the past hold you back. You got to press on. Don't let circumstances or anyone stand in your way.
That's it.
Only making yourself available for him to use you.
Yeah.
And, you know, you're good enough.
Mm-hmm.
Just see yourself.
Yeah.
I'm good enough for Christ to be for you using. Amen? So, amen.
Praise God.
Thank you, Father, for your precious word. Help us, Lord, to grow and go for you, Lord. Help us, Lord, to forgive and forget. Help us to let go and let God, Lord, Father, in Jesus' precious name, Lord. Thank you, Father.
Sure.
And you know, we don't want to close until you have an opportunity to make Jesus your Lord. Amen. We are closing this new day. We're closing this year. And if you haven't received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, now is the time. Amen. You're listening. You're watching. Now is the time. You know, all you have to do is say, Lord, I've sinned against you. I repent. Come into my life. I make you my Lord and Savior.
Yes.
And start changing. And start reading. And start pressing on with God. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. If you have sickness in your body, amen, whatever area of your body, just remember that by Jesus' stripes, you were healed.
Yes.
So you're a healed child of God. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Think about it is, receive it. I receive my healing in Jesus' name. That's all you have to say.
Amen.
Lord, I receive my healing in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. We rebuke that spirit of infirmity and we release his healing to flow all over you in Jesus' name. So praise God. In giving, you're watching and listening, go to our website, nbcbigben.com, and press that donate button. If you're mailing it, NBC P.O. Box 252, Marfa, Texas, 79843. Hallelujah. Just to let you know, God loves you and we love you. Amen. Praise God.